ready to go. Just did this loop, took me 20 minutes. This one will take a little longer because I'm gonna try to take it easy so I don't get water and mud everywhere. This is your entrance into the one way. This is two-way traffic on this section just to get down to the loop. Did see two deer already. One at the picnic table when I first got here and one on my first loop. Probably a decent place if you like to deer hunt. You can't shoot does at all. Archery, primitive weapons are at any time on this property. Antlered buck only the entire season. Well, antlered deer, I guess technically. Could be an antlered doe, but I've never seen one of those yet. I'm riding a 2022 Yamaha YFZ 450R. It is basically completely stock other than my handguards and of course my graphics. Now we're to the one-way section. I'm going to go out and hang a right. You could go a lot faster, and it is fun if you do. However, it is muddy, and I'm just doing video, so we're going to be leisurely, have a good time. You can see the trail. See what it's all about. There are no Jeeps or trucks, motorcycles and ATVs only. I've seen side-by-sides in here, but I'm not totally sure if they are legal or not. I would recommend checking before you bring a side-by-side up here. They could be a little too wide. There's a width limit, I think, of 54 inches. If it rains, it does get very slick. The leaves are pretty slick, but it's a fun little ride. Nothing too serious. Used to have a really hard hill climb. They've completely done away with that. Which I'm honestly not too brokenhearted about. It was very tough on a bike for me to get up. Of course, on this it was a breeze, but it was very steep, very rocky and rutted. I spend more time on the ground when I try to take a bike up it than I did on the bike, so. Very beautiful out here. It's more towards the wood. This is a feed bay. There is no one else here. a lot of times you'll come, there'll be no one else here though. So. I do like that it's one way. It makes it a little safer, I feel like. One of the few one-way trails in the area. And you can see, I mean, this is, would be amazing deer hunting territory here. And it, but there is private, close, but all of this, of course, is on public land. Georgia actually does really good, I feel like, managing the wildlife and having some trails for enjoying on your ATVs, dirt bikes, side-by-sides. They have plenty for jeeps and trucks as well. Let's see, we're really close to the private property here, but this is public property, so. They just happen to live in a little piece of heaven. It looks like they have an amazing view. Another little cabin. Go very slow, but the first trip around did not work out. All that mud water I just went through, you really couldn't see anything by the time I got through that. So since I'm trying the video, this is take two. You're going to cross the road that you drive in on. Not a whole lot of traffic, but yeah, still be a little cautious crossing the road. This is the other side. They totally redone this sign. Well, I say totally, not entirely, but took out the ridiculous part, in my opinion. And it's just not fun. I think we will have a lot more riders in here because of them redoing the entire hill. It's actually enjoyable versus an entire workout. This is Loper that goes to the lake. This is the trail. Although it's a really little jump. Nothing huge. Little fun. Have one high speed up here, you can do pretty well. They do a lot of turkey habitat improvement in here. Here's where they really work a lot on this trail. And they did a complete reroute of the direction it follows. It pretty much used to go straight up this mountain. Now we're side to side. A lot of switchbacks. The old trail went right through there, to the right. Now here's the all new, just added in. They just opened this back up. Just completed all the work. Well, as you can see, it is pretty narrow. Thanks to the Forest Service and the good state of Georgia for allowing people to have places like this to ride. I did wish North Carolina would kind of follow suit, but that's a different story entirely, so. If I would fit through some of these trees, but actually I'm not totally sure if they're legal or not in the first place. But this did make this trail longer than the 5.9 miles that was listed, but it used to be, because it was a straight shot to the top, and now we're just zigzagging back and forth. Down through there. Yay. Amateur. Wasn't quite sure which direction he's going still. still bringing my bike back over here and ride it as well. More manageable. And enjoyable. And there's the lake. I'm not sure you can see it, but it's a fun little section. Absolutely amazing. If you guys could see it or not, but I might see some more deer. Two already. That was the old trail came right down straight off the mountain. To the second road crossing. Now we're back on the side of the road that you park on. We're ready to go down by the lake. Here. just from Blairsville to pretty much is in Blairsville. It's where the it starts. Good fishing. Bass, stripers, crappie, or crappie, however you feel the need to pronounce those. There's a squirrel. Hopefully we'll have some fishing videos a little later on as well. Right here is where I saw the second deer. I wanted to go right through there. I'm standing there. Pretty low. Pretty fun dump right here. Probably looking pretty good. Fun little fix right there. We're almost done with the loop. Back to the two-way traffic. Which I'm the only one in here today, but we are back.